Okay, it's June 5th, 2017. I gotta be careful here. It's 11 o'clock. We were out in the garden here, and we had to be very careful. We put a feeder out just for bees because they were getting all of the ones for the hummingbirds, and they are again. And I'm gonna show you. You know, it's one thing about caring for these bees. Now look at this. This is for the hummingbirds. I'm gonna zoom in with this because I took a picture of it with my phone. Regular phone, which is my camera pictures. Oh, I can't focus. Okay, where do you see this other one? I mean, my God, I don't know if we made a mistake of putting it so close, because it's about 20 feet away from the house to try to pull them away from the hummingbird feeders like this one. Now, I'm gonna keep going, zoom in. I'm gonna zoom out to get it focused because they're just like caked on here. Trying not to move, they're just caked down every hole that there is. Okay, that's for pollinating the flowers and the garden around our garden. And when we put this out for them, and I mean, I walked by this and I got, oh, I took a picture, but it was so close, I didn't want to startle them and have them come after me. Look at that. Oh, shoot, I'm on the ground. I'm looking at the field with my eyes. The bees are all over that thing. Keep flying by me. I'm just staying, remaining still. Okay, they keep coming by me, so I'm gonna just back up a little bit. But that's what we did for them. And like I said, now they're going over to the house there, and they're getting on a couple of the feeders. And there's one that were all over that one feeder. Right there, that one right there, the one on the left. And the hummingbirds can't compete, man. They'll die if they get stung by these things. And Tracy and I were out here with the hoe and her on her hands and knees. weed eating and hoeing this one up. This is the number two garden. We got a couple, torch sunflower there, torch on the corner. Right in the center is a torch. And then the others are the yellow sunflowers. Torch, yellow, all these are yellow. That's a torch. And we got five cucumbers now. One, and you see the little leaves down there somewhere. Big one there. There's two little leaves. We got those two trestles right there for the goal. It's about 7 feet back and then 3 feet behind that. We got a pepper down there, which that tape is blocking. Pepper there. These were in the house. Just went ahead and planted them out here. And if they survive, they survive. If not, no, they won't. Pepper. And then we got lettuce that we planted. I thought they were gone, but we got one there. Where were those stakes that broke off? It's like a little lettuce head. And we got four broccoli back there. And we got a big sunflower right there. I don't know what that one is. We just let it go with the zucchini. We got three zucchini in the house. We're going to juice them probably. This one here. That small one right there. And that one, big one right there. There's two on there now. They're kind of about the size of small, medium-sized pickles. I'm gonna walk out here onto this loose soil. It's nice, rich too. You can see how dark and rich it is. But the garlic, there's 25 garlic over there. We're gonna make that into three rows. Put 12 or 14 in each row in August. After we harvest up those garlic, you take one bulb and then you break out the cloves and plant them. And then we got watermelon here. I'm going to go from the east side. We planted three Swiss chard down here. There's two Tobias beans right there. Don't recall. This is a bean right here. That's a watermelon. We had planted another watermelon there, but it didn't grow. But there's two up there. This one and the one on the left down there are the same, and then the other one is the other type of watermelon. One is Waltham, the long one, and short. The other one is a short sugar baby. Yeah, I know. I was videotaping that, and I showed the honeybees on the other part. There's two beans. okra, that's where I think we planted somewhere. There's two okra down there. There's one right there. I planted another okra right down in there. Two okra, actually, technically. Purple hull pea, two purple hull peas, two purple hull peas, and that's what that other one is. Purple hull pea, and that hull right there by the center thing. And then these are cantaloupe. No, I take it back. These are watermelon coming toward me. They're going east. And this is a cantaloupe. It's traveling west. Usually they run north, but I don't know why, so we just let it go. Here's your American-made, or your imported cinder block. I dropped it down on the muddy ground. Look how it just broke off. Piece over there. Those pieces. Thought I had another piece of it too. Oh yeah, right there. I ain't just dropping down to the muddy, hard mud, you know, it's like, not solid hard, it's thick, but it's just dropping and it broke like that. Yeah, imagine that being someone's foundation of a house. These are two cantaloupe. Black-eyed peas. And dummy me, not realizing. I've been making these fences with the tomato stakes and fencing. And I make the tall part up on top and put the bottom part in. And I should have been doing it the opposite way, like this one here. We have the long going down. Look at how the beans are crawling to the top of the tomato stakes. And I got string on there trying to lead them now after all this. See, this is too late to take this one apart and flip it. I could do this little short one right there. You know, it's attached to it. And then here, those giant, I want to say emerald beans, but I'm not sure if that's what that was. I have to look on a previous video, if I did a video of it. That one there too. I used chicken wire. I broke the tomato sticks three times and put them in there. Same thing with that in there. These are white beans or northern beans. I don't know if those are considered native beans or not, but they're northern or white beans. You get white beans, mashed potatoes, and chicken. Two beans in each hole. Now these got to go at least until the end of July for them to be picked. I want them as beans. I don't want them as cooked green beans. You can cook a lot of beans with the shaw pot on it, the casing. This is good Muller's Stollard. You know that by the pink flowers that are on it. You got pods all over that too. All our beans we're letting go to what they call seed until they're in a shell. That's a good Muller's Stollard. How it's coming up. I should have had the fencing, like say, inverted so that the long part was in the ground and the top part where the fencing would be where that is and it'd go across. I took a couple and attached one onto that. Going back, same thing here. I attached, see how that one's throwing one up onto that string? Going back. And like I say, since they've already started entwining here, I can't do it because this one's already all over this tomato stick. But I did have this sturdy green one here to hold it up because of the weight. I did that little short lead right there. I flipped that one. And then I'll go down to the chicken wire. This is the last year I should have, everything I know now is, I mean, everything we've been learning over the last 6 years, 5 years, we've implemented little by little and changed and learned. See, but this is the one thing I just didn't click with me until today about not having it, where the small end is in the ground, and you got the fence, and you got all this up here. That should be in the ground, because they'll crawl up it regardless, and then they'll have fencing on the top part to crawl across. God, I can't believe how simple that was. God, I can't remember. Anyway. So, mainly I was showing you what the bees look like out there, and I just want to get up that about the beans, the fencing. I just had it upside down all this time. Because I'm left-handed, let's put it that way. And the peppers are coming out pretty decent here. This first row was five of them. They were looking so shaggy and whatnot. You can see them now. I got eggshells down there right now. And then there's nice tomatoes here. I'm going to get off the garden. I'm on the west end right now. See that tomato right there? And that one right there. Again, that one. That one. And then we got the basil, I think it is. That purplish color one there. One there. The only ones that survived out here, we had a couple others, but they were so small. But those really did good. I like to have about 10 of those out here. They're supposed to ward off insects. This was a real small, scraggy looking tomato. Look at it, it's going okay. That's a pepper that insects were getting at, and it's coming back using the mesious earth around it. That's another tomato plant. And I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more sticks for tomatoes out here. And one, that stake right there, this stake right here. 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 peppers. Right where that cooler is, there was another hole. We can make another pepper there. So we'll have 5 more tomatoes and 5 or 6 peppers out here yet. They're all growing in the house. We got a lot in the house yet. So, in about another month, we'll have, well, the zucchini is already growing out, pulling out. We're getting cute. Zucchini is about 7-8 inches long, about as long as that hammer handle. Actually, a little bit shorter than that, but about that size. And, whew, man.